Gift first released in April of 2005, and since then, has basically taken over the entirety of the source code control space. But it's by no means the first. There are some arguments for some precursors back in 1962, but the generally accepted first actual source code control system is SCCS, aptly named Source Code Control System. It was 1972. Do you expect better tech naming? But we are not here to talk about the origin of source code control. Nowadays, the majority of people have pretty much only interacted with Git. Maybe if you've worked for like Mozilla, you've used something else. If you worked for Facebook, you've used something else. There's a few places here and there where other things are holding on, but the majority of people, Git's the only thing you'll ever use, basically, unless something in the future comes along. But if you look around long enough, you're gonna start noticing some really weird commit dates. Here we have Wine Release 0.02, committed June 30th, 1993. Here is the Git GCC mirror for the very first commit. November 23rd, 1988. Here is the Unix history repo, January 1st, 1970, and here is a Microsoft repo for Basic M6502, July 28th, 1978. Now, the weird thing about all these dates is they all predate the creation of Git. Git came out in 2005, so how are you committing things to Git in 1978? In 1970, in 1988, in 1993. None of these are dates indicating the age of the file. That's a whole different date. That's not something stored directly in Git. These are dates indicating when the commit supposedly took place, but that doesn't make any sense. Well, actually it does, just not in the way that you'd normally be using Git, because Git doesn't really care about dates. All it cares about is the order of the commits being made. The date is something for you as a user to see when the commit was made. So if we go over to the Git documentation specifically for Git commit, there is an option in here called --date. Now, normally when you make a commit, it will take the current date from your system. You don't have to use that, you can override that if you want to. Regarding date formats, check the date format section. We can use the Git internal format, RFC 2822, or ISO 8601. Any of these are supported, feel free to use whichever one you want. Personally, I like ISO 8601, but you do you. They'll all work the same way. Okay, here we have an example repo. Right now I've got a file already added, so let's do a Git commit. And if we go and, I don't know, just put something here, I'm going to delete the repo anyway. Please don't actually name your commits like this. If we then do a Git log, we can see that commit was made on October 7th at 2:30 and 24 seconds, 2025, with my time zone here. But we can go and change that by using the date option. Let me just go and make another file to commit. This time, let's do Git commit --date. And then use this date right here. This is January 1st, 2000 at midnight. And instead, it's gonna be using that date. Now, I'm not setting my time zone, so it's gonna use the time zone set on my system. But it could be basically anything else we want. If I want this to be, let's say, 1975, we can do that as well. We could even go and set it in the future. Let's set it to 2038. And that is totally valid as well. Now, there are some edge cases that we cannot go around. We're not able to go to a time that would be before GMT 1970 at January 1st. This is a limit on 32-bit integer numbers, but this is not a 32-bit integer stored date because we can actually go above 2038 and that not be a problem. But there is a limit on the forwards direction as well. I did that wrong. For some reason, we can't go above 2099. If we try to, it resets it to our current year. Why does it do this? I have no idea. I'm sure there is a technical reason for it, and I'm sure this is not going to be forgotten about until 2099 and then break a bunch of repos. Surely no one's going to forget about this one. Now, we've already made a commit to this repo, so what happens if we set the date to be before the commit we've already made? Let's just go 1978, and let's go and add some nonsense in here. Save it. It was fine to go and add that. Let's do a git log. And that's fine. So we have a commit that takes place after our previous commit, but is supposedly earlier in time. Git does not care about the date for ordering the commits. That's not something it uses. Now, whilst you can do this, and it's a thing that will work and probably won't break your repo, you probably shouldn't do this. In the majority of cases, there isn't a reason to do so. And whilst this is going to work fine with Git, GitHub, GitLab, I don't know about random software that interacts with Git. Some of them might be handling dates in a weird way, and for some reason, actually put a lot of emphasis on the date. So, just to ensure that nothing breaks, I would not recommend you do this, let alone the fact that in the majority of cases when you are doing this, is just going to make the log look really confusing. There are valid reasons like cherry picking an old commit that has a weird date, and yeah, that's totally fair, but like, this, when you're just committing something normally, don't have misordered commit dates. It's a bad idea. Now, whilst you shouldn't, this is totally valid on GitHub. You can make a commit in 2094. It does seem like it handles dates weirdly on GitHub. It says the latest commit was 7 months ago, which would be the March one. So it doesn't seem to handle future dates very well. Probably because there's not any sensible reason why you would be setting the commit date to the future. Yeah. There is another valid reason to mess with the date, not into the future, but into the past. Let's say you have a bunch of changes from before you were using a source code control system, and you want to make sure those are in reasonably usable commits rather than just being one giant commit, and you don't want to just commit them with your current date. You want them to be somewhat representative of when the work was done. And the far less important reason is drawing funny pictures on the GitHub graph. The GitHub commit graph, because you can use it to set the date you want to be using and then draw, I don't know, a penis on the GitHub commit graph rather than doing actual work in the shape of a penis. Whatever you feel like doing, totally up to you. However, there is another route for the date to be weird that is a lot more reasonable to do, which a lot of projects are definitely going to see, which is what Wine probably did, is what GCC probably did, and what a lot of other projects probably did. They didn't go and just manually backdate everything. At least they probably didn't. I can't imagine any reason why they would have done this manually. They were using a source code control system before using Git. And this is a Git mirror of GCC. GCC existed on another source code control system before using Git. Some of these projects may have been on SVN, CVS, RCS, SCCS, and they didn't just delete their old repos. They didn't go and delete all of those old commits because there might come a reason why you might want to see that old commit. You might want to go and revert something or know who did certain work or something like that. So many of them, when they moved over to Git or have a mirror for Git, used a Git migration tool. And the results are going to vary depending on which tool you're using, where you're migrating from, how many migrations you've done, because some didn't just go from what they were using directly to Git. Some have done, you know, two or three migrations before that. But the goal of doing a migration rather than just taking the code and then putting it into a new fresh Git repo is to retain that old history. And that old history, most likely as a side effect, is going to have those old dates. Those dates being loaded into Git, most likely using that same system of dash dash date that I showed you earlier, which most likely comes with the same sort of restrictions, but I can't imagine you're bringing any code from before 1972, with SCCS being the first option. Again, I don't know what's going to happen into the future post 2099. Somebody should look into that and make sure that isn't actually a real problem. So from now on, when you see someone talking about a weird date in Git and they didn't know that Git was around in 1980, you can then explain to them, well, this is not from a time traveler. This is not some weird exploit in Git. This is basic functionality built into the program that you probably haven't interacted with, because reasonably, there's not really that many reasons to go and interact with it. There are some, but you don't use it most of the time. Just doing a normal commit is the better way to do it for 99% of cases. Is this important information? No, not at all. But now you know. So let me know. Did you happen to know about this being a feature? Have you run across repos that have weird dates and were confused about them? Or did you understand all of this innately? You just understand everything. I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, let me know down below and go like the video. If you want to go subscribe as well. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Stanley Barapay, link in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and get out of here.